to a show, Everything Under the Sun, where we talk about everything under the sun. New week, new episode.
Why you keep doing the accent, man? Why? You're preparing yourself for Australia, is it?
Yeah, man.
Stupid.
No, okay. Yeah, so new week, new episode. I know we took a break last week.
Because we were going through stuff.
Yeah, we just had a lot of things to... We just need some time to rest and, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We do it for 12 weeks straight, man.
Yeah, man. Crazy. I don't know. I don't know how they do it. Like, yeah. I don't know how people who do podcasts, like,
I mean, the momentum. I don't know, because, like, I feel like for us, it's like we're doing everything on our own.
Yeah, yeah, that's
true. We're, like, setting up, setting down.
There's no team behind it.
There's no team, yeah. It's just three of us.
Yeah.
But today, there's just two of us, because Adrian couldn't make it.
Yeah.
But...
Yeah.
It's okay.
It's fine.
The show must go on.
Yeah.
Yes.
And today, if you've read the title... it's a pretty heavy topic today that we would like to address. And it's concerning Asian hate, anti-Asian hate, specifically, in the US. I've seen all over Instagram, like, you know, an old lady being shoved around and like some people even losing their lives, because of this. So, to start off, what do the statistics look like? I mean, because you're more of a numbers person, right? So like...
Okay, like, so we just searched it up, right?
Yeah.
And they said that, this is from NBC News, and it says that there are about like 3,800 anti-Asian racist incidents in the past year alone.
Ooh.
Right. So if you divide it up, that's around like at least 10, more than 10 a day.
Wow.
You know, and it says that it's mostly against women. Mm. So it's like... Yeah. And then... Mm-hmm. Like, another stat says that there's a 1,900% rise in Asian hate crimes across the whole COVID period.
That's been reported. Right.
Yeah, and like a lot of cases go unreported because, like, not everyone wants to report it, and we'll talk about that later.
But I don't think, like, some of them, they aren't in a position to report because, like, what if you're really, like, severely injured, you know? Then you can't bring yourself to the police station, right? You got to go straight to the hospital, you know?
But, like, I mean... Even if you go to the hospital and then you can still report it, ma.
Oh, yeah,
in the sense where...
True.
But I feel like... Okay, let's talk about it now, right? Mm. I feel like the reason why a lot of people are not reporting about it is because I feel like some of them are just not like... They just give up already. Because like, if you think about it, I don't think the police are doing anything about it.
I think the police... Yeah, I think... Okay, but... Okay, when you talk about the police, then that brings up the Black Lives Movement, right?
Yeah,
and then
exactly.
Like how the police were actually the ones who acted like, you know...
Were the perpetrators
of the whole like thing. But then like, I feel like for Asians, the police aren't really too... Like, I feel like they have too much on their hands. Yeah, so there have been a rise in like anti-Asian hate task forces. Like major cities like New York or something.
Yeah.
And okay, we obviously don't live in the US.
Yeah.
So we don't feel it as much. But then I feel like as Asians and as people who are Asian and we like have a platform as YouTube and Spotify, it is socially responsible to address it, you know?
Yeah.
I feel like if people don't talk and don't speak up about it, then it will just go unaddressed and it will go unnoticed.
True.
And more Asians will start being afflicted, you know?
I mean, we're just giving our two cents on this matter.
Yeah,
And I don't know, but I feel like racism isn't something that is uncommon to us.
Yeah, and it's nothing new as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel.
Because even in Malaysia, because like we're a multiracial country and everything, and... I think the generation now don't really feel it more, but I think if you ask like our parents' generation or even our grandparents,
because there was a kind of civil disruption.
Yeah, there was like a racial incident, a big racial incident.
Back in the 1970s, was it?
I'm not really sure. I didn't study Malaysia sejarah, so but
I mean there is precedence of like racist acts. Mm. I mean violence. Leading from racism in our country.
Yeah, but I feel like Malaysia has handled it pretty well in the sense where, like I said before, our generation now don't really feel it because there isn't like some big like, I mean, okay, la,
there's no big civil
there's
war
no big situation la, yeah, but basically our country is still pretty racist and pretty biased towards a like certain race la.
Recently, like as of modern times,
yeah,
we are racist, but it's not like outwardly racist, you know.
Okay,
like our country is more, oh, we just keep it within our racial group because of,
yeah,
like,
it's true,
let's say they have like anti-Chinese sentiments, let's say. Then they only keep it within their group. Or let's say the Chinese have something against Indians.
They
don't outrightly display it.
Yeah.
They don't show it, lah.
But the thing in America is that it's like,
it's a free country.
Yeah. But what I don't get is that America was always supposed to be portrayed as the country where,
the land of immigrants.
The land of immigrants and, or the land of freedom and stuff like that. Where everyone has rights, everyone has rights. But then that's not what we're seeing here.
Yeah.
And which just like,
just pretty sad, lah. Because I felt, as like growing up, I always thought that America was like the land of, you know, freedom. You know, I wanted to go to America.
The American dream and everything, right?
Like growing up with like movies such as High School Musical, all these other like movies about America, it really instilled in me that America was the place to be, right? But then now growing up, I feel like it's starting to not be the place that I imagined it to be. Like it's turning less from the paradise that I envisioned at first into whatever hellscape it is now.
I mean, I think that's the thing about like Western media or media. Yeah. They try to paint a picture of something that isn't quite what it seems. And now, like, as we grow older, we start to realize what the real world actually looks like.
Yeah,
and there's so many of these underlying issues that actually have been happening, have been going on for quite a while, but it's like it's just rearing its head now.
Yeah,
because of the whole COVID thing and everything.
Yeah, there was this senator that I watched on. I don't know if she's a senator, but she's a politician of some sort.
Yeah.
She's like an Asian politician in America, and she actually brought up that, like back in the 1900s or something.
1800s or something like
1800,
that.
When America was first founded, like they actually got Chinese immigrants to actually build the railroad, right?
Yeah.
And you know, Chinese immigrants have been in America since forever, you know?
Yeah.
And anti-Asian hate has always been going on, but I feel like now it's taken a front and center like position because of the rise of social media firstly. And also like the, because everyone has a mobile phone and everyone has the access to the internet.
Yeah.
And like we can actually broadcast these violent acts, you know? Like compared to before, like let's say back in the 1800s or something, when a white guy would hit an Asian worker on the train tracks, like no one would know. Only the Asian community would know. But now it's like everyone knows about it, you know? And I feel like it's kind of a dick move lah from Americans,
but
to like, you know, you're abusing the people that helped build your country, you know what I mean?
And it's not even just about like being grateful for someone to help build your country. It's just like basic humanity, you know, like basic.
And
I
think the main sentiment of the Americans who hate Asian people and who are anti-Asian are because, oh, they think the virus comes from Asia or something.
Yeah.
They think all Asians are responsible for the coronavirus. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Stupid, like, honestly. Like, okay, like, I don't know. Like, even if someone is, okay, basically it's not, like, let's just not go there. But like I said before, it's basic humanity, like how you treat others, like, you know, like treat others the way you want to be treated in the sense. And you just don't go around pushing or like taking advantage of the weak, or especially the elderly. Like so many cases of people are not just against like Asian women, but against the elderly folk, which is something I really...
Do you see the video of the Thai man? Like the Thai man who got shoved?
Yeah. Like so many videos online of like graphic videos of like people getting shoved from behind and everything. Yeah. And especially...
And they're all old people.
Yeah, it's old people. Like,
they are practically harmless. And they can't even... They wouldn't even... They don't even have the strength to fight back. Yeah. Why would you hit... they're practically defenseless, lah. You know, like I don't see the point in hitting old people because they're old. Give them a break, you know.
Yeah, but I don't know, and yeah, I know, like, especially not all Americans are like that, lah. But basically, to us non-Americans watching from an outsider's point of view, like I don't think America is a safe place anymore. Like, I have a few friends who are planning to go to America to study and everything. I just tell them, like, no, don't do it. Don't do it. Because, like, you're Asian, you don't really know what happened, what's going to happen there. And we're not saying that all Americans are bad or America is a bad place, but just painting a picture of how this thing has actually affected, negatively impacted our views on America.
Like, every time I see a video of, like, old people being hit, right, I just think of my grandparents.
Yeah, like, those people who push the old people down, right? Think of your grandparents. Like, what if someone just shoves your grandparents down?
Would you like that?
How would you feel?
How would you feel? Yeah, exactly. I just can't get behind why you would just hurt an old person.
Actually,
you know?
Why do you think someone... Okay, what do you think racism stems from?
I think it stems from the... Like, okay, because racism... That people who are racist, they view other people as being different from them.
Mm-hmm.
So it could be through the skin color, through the culture, through the beliefs, you know. Let's talk about... let's draw a comparison between white people and Asian people, right? Yeah. White people see themselves as superior, right? I'm not saying this as a emotional out of emotional sentiment, but it is like... Like back then, they did see themselves as the superior race. Yeah, and they saw like indigenous people as, you know, the less evolved humans.
Because basically they colonized like half of Asia or something like that, right?
Half of Asia. Yeah. And when they went to Australia, they actually thought of the indigenous people as like, you know, lesser evolved humans, which they weren't. They are actually like normal humans.
The British shipped their prisoners over to Australia.
Yeah.
So like, we're not talking out of this like based on an emotional based on emotional sentiment.
I mean, it's been written in history, la. Like, you know, they have viewed themselves as the superior race. And I think racism stems from the fact that you see someone else as different from you because of how they look and how they speak or their language or their the color of their skin, you know?
Yeah.
It's pretty simple, la. It's just that. Yeah. But when it comes to hating someone because of the color of their skin, I just don't get, like...
Yeah.
Like, what's the point?
I actually don't really understand
how
those kind of people think, in the sense where... Yeah, I don't know, like, because I think, talking about Malaysia again, us as Malaysians, this generation, I think we're pretty sheltered, and... I don't know, maybe it's because we both went to like private schools growing up. Maybe in public schools it's different. You guys can tell us how your experience were, like, if there's like any racism thingy happening in public school.
Mm.
But like Malaysia, we have a lot of songs like, oh, Satu Malaysia, we are just like one nation, one country. And it doesn't matter that we're made up of different races, but we're still part of like a single community. Like. And I think that upbringing is very important.
Because
like those people who are like racist, or those people who are like attacking people of different races, definitely I would say like the apple doesn't fall apart from the tree.
Yeah, it comes from,
honestly,
I feel like it starts from the family.
It does. Yeah,
I like that point that you brought up. And also I feel like in many ways, even in Malaysia, we have been brought up to think that we've been brought up in a racist manner as well.
That's true.
I feel like okay,
there's a lot of basically there are a lot of negative stereotypes. Yeah,
like a lot of times my grandparents or my aunts or my uncles would say, like, oh, if you don't finish your rice, the apu nene will come and catch you.
Yeah.
And apu nene, they're referencing, I mean, they obviously mean Indians, right?
Yeah.
And that's honestly just...
Yeah, but like there are a lot of negative...
It's a racist remark.
It is through and through.
And we like unknowingly we just keep saying it and we keep like, you know.
It's true, lah.
Echoing it through the generations.
As much as we say that, or I say that Malaysia is like, we have it better now in terms of racism, but actually racism actually runs really deep.
Yeah.
And I feel like every single one of us, we are a little bit racist, whether we realize it or not.
Yeah.
Honestly, because like it comes with the upbringing, lah. Because I feel like racism is like thinking of, like what you said, thinking of yourself better than the other race, or just like, still
feeling, I think it's
feeling negative emotions towards a particular kind of people, right? Just because of it could be just because of a bad experience that you had with this person of a particular race. Yeah, and it leads you to think that, oh, all people are like that. You know what I mean? And like,
which is like basically generalization. You're generalizing and demonizing a whole community of people just because of one person and one negative experience you shared with that person.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think a lot of times with racism, it's very situational. It's very, it depends on the situation and the consequences that you're in. Because, for example, I was attacked by, let's say I was attacked by, I'm not Chinese and I was attacked by a Chinese, you know, then I would be hardwired to think that every Chinese person is out to get me, you know, and I would feel threatened. And I feel like Asia, not just anti-Asian hate, but like racism stems from also the feeling of being threatened. Like you have something to lose if you don't defend yourself against them. You know, like, oh, it could be, the sentiment could be, oh, they're stealing our jobs. Or like, oh,
yeah,
they're coming, they have a virus with them.
Yeah, you know? It could be out of a very selfish nature. La. But like the thing about anti-Asian hate was that it was all unprovoked.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, the fella just...
It's very unprovoked.
The fella just waiting for a bus, you know, the old uncle. And then the guy just kung fu kick him, like, go to practice in a gym or something. La.
And there was this Filipino guy that I saw on YouTube, like, he was just waiting for the train to get to work, right?
Yeah.
Normal day. He's just minding his own business. Okay, then this guy came and like kicked his back, slashed his face.
Yeah.
And he screamed for help, but no one was there to help him.
Yeah, that's like, the thing.
No one came up to him and, you know, ushered him to the hospital. No one stopped the attacker. And he was left like with a scar here, and he was like, he had to try and close it with his hands, and he saw blood spilling out. And that to me is just so...
Honestly, if you see a person in need and you don't help because they're of a different race, then you're racist as well.
Yeah, if you're not part of the solution, then you're part of the problem. You know what I mean? Like,
it's true.
And also, like, I think the video that hit me the most and what drove me to feel like you know, talking about this today is like... there's a video of a US senator. I don't know what state. I'm not sure, but he's Asian, right?
Yeah.
And then he actually took off his shirt
middle of the meeting,
meeting.
On camera,
in front of all the news and in front of all the reporters. And he was like, Is this patriotism? Yeah, is this patriot enough for you?
Yeah.
You know, like, I
mean, patriotic. Because basically, just a backstory, this guy fought in like, he a was part wars. Of the US Army yeah, right, yeah, and stuff yeah. like that. And he got like a big.
He had like, yeah, a over big scar.
His, yeah, abdomen here. And like, I guess a lot of people just like in terms of America, they just look at the color of the skin. Because American is more racially diverse than Malaysia, definitely. Mm-hmm. In the sense where they have like Latinos, they have like Mexicans, blacks. And they have blacks. And stuff like that. And a lot of people just generalize like other people based on the color of their skin. Without realizing that actually... You're all part of the same country. Like, people can be of a different skin color, but they could have been living in America longer than you. Think about it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just because you fit into the general stereotype of, like...
An American.
Oh, white American. White guy, blonde hair. I don't know. Like, you know. Doesn't mean that... Yeah, like, you're superior to other people or what.
It doesn't make you more American because you're white.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, like... An Asian is also American.
Yeah.
An African is also American if they've been in the country. If they're legal immigrants, you know what I mean? Yeah.
But I don't know about you, but I feel like, I don't know, the whole anti-Asian thingy, it just became like, okay, I wouldn't say a trend, but it just became more, what is it called?
Mainstream
this year. Right? At the start of this year or something, then there were more media coverage. But then I feel like even with that, there isn't a lot of support or there isn't a lot of people talking about it as the Black Lives Matter movement that happened last June, which is also like...
Pretty sad, actually.
Yeah. It makes me ask, for the Black Lives Matter, there were so many celebrities like...
Endorsing it
and like, yeah. Why?
What I found interesting was that like for one of the first videos I saw of Asian hate was a black person shoving a old Asian grandmother, and that just like, well, we fought for you and you're doing
it's true
and you're doing this for us,
it's true, know?
Like, it's like I just don't get it. Yeah, it's just disgusting.
Yeah Well, I don't know, because they have a term POC, right? Person of color, right?
I think so. Yeah. I think that's what they use in America.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not sure. Really very up to date with those.
We're not American.
Yeah, I mean, we're just giving our two cents, definitely, yeah. And sharing our experience about racism in Malaysia, generally.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, like I said, like, so many people, I think a lot, like, the Asian community also rallied with the black community.
Yeah.
With the Black Lives Matter movement that happened last year and everything. But, like, this year, we ain't seeing much of that.
Yeah.
You know, and there isn't a lot of, like, Asian coverage over it and stuff like that. And last time you even had like the black squares thingy.
But I feel like that didn't.
I really didn't see a point.
Yeah.
But
I mean, again, okay, let's just talk about that. Like, okay, like, let's talk about
what are the steps that we can.
Yeah. Yeah. Sure.
Like the steps
that
to
we can
help or to alleviate the
yeah.
Yeah.
Because I mean, I said earlier that if you're not part of the solution, then you're part of the problem, right? Mm-hmm. So I think in Malaysia, what we could do is just stop generalizing, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, stop generalizing one person to the entire culture. Let's say you had a bad experience with one person of a different race.
Mm.
You don't have to demonize the entire culture because of that one person,
yeah,
you know?
Correct, correct.
And I think one more thing that we could do is just be nicer to our foreign workers. Like,
yeah, it's true.
Like
very true.
The people who come from Bangladesh, Myanmar, like they're our waiters, you know. They're the security guards.
You know?
They're the people preparing our food. If you don't be nice to them, right? What if they like put weird stuff in our food?
Actually,
you know,
that's a concern. So you never know. Yeah, so, like cook your food at home. not being racist, but yeah. Anyways, like it's true. Like for Malaysia, for us, besides like the Malays, the Indians, the Chinese, like we have to be more considerate towards like the foreign workers who are working here.
That includes
like our security guards, our maids, especially at home.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they risk their lives, they come over to work and everything. And the least we can do is to show them some
respect that they serve.
Not as just because like, oh, we're all about anti-racism and we want to be woke and respect everyone. No, but it's just like basic human respect. Like,
it's basic. It's the fundamental human.
Yeah.
It's the fundamental thing. It's the basis of being human. You know what I mean?
It's like sort of like what I said, like, treat others the way you want to be treated.
Yeah.
You know?
Like, and don't. Yeah, because, okay, there was once in my high school, there was this guy that I met. And he was really friendly with us, right? And he actually, when I got to know him, he was actually a doctor back in Nepal, right? He actually studied medicine in Nepal.
Wow.
But because there was like, I think...
The earthquake. Was it the earthquake?
I don't know, but there was some thing happened in the country and he had no job, right?
Mm.
So he basically had to you know, get out of his country to find a job.
Mm.
And he came to Malaysia and... This guy had a medical degree, right?
Right.
He studied for I don't know how many years, but he probably studied a long time to be a practicing doctor.
Wow.
But he came to Malaysia and he got a job as a security guard.
Man.
And that just blows my mind. I'm like, man, he's so much smarter than us, you know?
Yeah.
But he's being offered a low paying job and that just didn't make sense to me. That didn't sit right with me.
But I guess that really highlights the reality of life, in the sense where you don't really know who you're actually talking to, you don't really know the impact you have on those around you, and you don't really know what others are going through.
The foreign workers you may be ill-treating may actually be doctors, lawyers, or like accountants in their home country, but they had no choice but to come out to, you know,
it's true,
provide a better living for their families.
It's true.
They like all of them. They send their money back home, and you know they kind of. I mean, that's how they support their family, you know?
And, like, I heard a politician saying once that, oh, the foreign workers are stealing our jobs and everything, and we have to deport them. But the thing is, like, the foreign workers are doing jobs that, honestly, us Malaysians wouldn't want to do.
Yeah, they are the backbone of our economy.
It's true. Like, you look at a lot of them in construction. Yeah. Or even, like, let's say, garbage collection.
Yeah.
Like, honestly, like, us Malaysians, we view it as such a, like, a disgusting job, honestly. Because, like, you're collecting trash. But, honestly, the people who are doing it are the foreign workers and they are actually so important. Like, imagine if you do deport all of them, I would guarantee,
country would be full of trash.
Yeah, no one would want to do it. Like, no Malaysian would actually want to do the job, honestly. Yeah. Unless you are one of them, then...
Kudos to you, man.
Yeah, good for you.
Good on you.
But honestly, Yeah, they're doing the jobs that no one wants to do. And that doesn't mean that
they're any less than you.
They're any less than us. That's right. Yeah. You know, each of us have a part to play in like the economy. Yeah,
for sure, man. And like even in tourism alone, right? Mm. I think they're also a pretty big factor in like local tourism, because us Malaysians, we want to like go elsewhere to travel, right? But then they've come to a new country to work, right? And so while they work, they will also like, you know, explore the city lah, and you know, spend money on this and that. And that actually would drive our you know, our imports.
Yeah. Support local.
Yeah.
Support local. I mean, like, one more thing is that we just have to show grace to those around us, I feel. Because like then again, we say like, you don't know what other people are going through, or you don't know what experience other people have. So that we shouldn't just outrightly judge a person just because they have racist behavior. Okay? I'm not saying it to defend a racist person. Because honestly, if you're being racist, then you're on the wrong side of the equation, lah, basically. But you might not know what the person have been going through. Like, went through with a person of a particular race. Like we said, like, although it's wrong to generalize, I feel like we should just really show grace to those around us and just slowly educate them back. Like, I guess us as a younger generation, I don't know if older folks hear it, what they would think, lah. Because I know a lot of older people will be like, yeah, you youngster, don't know what you're talking about, lah. You know, last time, you don't know how they treat us and that kind of thing. But, like, even towards our parents, I feel like us as kids, even though they might not take us seriously, we can just, like, you know, tell them it's not nice to be racist, you know?
I mean, a little goes a long way. So even though you may not see the effects immediately, but the more you be nice to people, the more you treat people as equals, then, I mean, I think things will change eventually. Yeah. It just takes one step.
I guess just to wrap it all up, don't belittle, like, the voice that you have or the impact that you might have to the people around you. Honestly, not everyone can be the voice which changes entire generation or if shifts the whole movement of, like, let's say, anti-Asian hate in America or just, like, or whether in Malaysia, not everyone is meant to be, like, the vocal person standing up for the movement. But what we can do is just do our part to the people that
community.
Yeah, God has placed around us and stuff like that to just be nice. And yeah, I really believe that you really wouldn't know the impact that you have on a person, like what Isaac shared about. Just being nice, just talking to a security guard, you know, like some people, when the guard like wave at them, even in like my guard community, right?
They just ignore,
you know. Yeah. Like I see people like, you know?
They were waving at you as a sign of respect. You know, it's like a salute. It's like a military salute. But they're doing this because they're security guards, you know?
And like, be nice to the waiters in your restaurant and everything. Just be nice to everyone you meet. I don't care. Like, to me, there's only one sort of race, right? It's the human race. You don't you don't break it up into Chinese, Malay, Indian, whatever. Yeah.
If you think about it, there's honestly no point. And it's honestly, I feel like what's holding us back as a culture in order to move forward is racism. Like, If everyone started treating each other as equals and started treating each other as human beings, I don't think we would be in the spot where we are today. You know? There won't be inequalities in I don't know.
And I feel like that solves the whole problem. It's not a magic bullet lah, but that would help a lot in terms of other forms of inequality, like especially gender inequality, you know? Like, men are definitely not any better than women in the sense where, like, what other people want to think lah, right? Yeah. And you know, just treat people the way you want to be treated. I know it's the third time I'm saying this, but like, yeah.
I think we'll end with the words of Harry Styles. Treat people with kindness.
Did he really say that?
It's his song.
Oh, okay. I don't listen to Harry Styles, but anyways, I guess that's just our two cents on
the whole situation.
Yeah, anti-Asian hate and just racism in general.
Yeah, man. So I think that's it. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe and leave a comment down below. Follow us on Instagram and Spotify
and Apple Podcasts. Yeah, follow us on Instagram at everythingunderthesun.mp4. And like, comment, subscribe. You can DM us. Let us know what you would like to hear us talk about.
Next.
Anything that we want to do, like sort of a reaction video. So if you all have like any like funny videos that you all want us
to, like a try not to laugh challenge or something. Yeah.
You all have any videos they want us to react to or something, you can just send them in. And we try to do something with it. So yeah, I think that's all for today. Thank you all so much for watching, and we'll see you.